Really? Hi, my name's Simon. I run a website called waitingforfriday.com where I blog about electronics projects. The chaps at Distrelec have contacted me and asked me to do some product reviews. So in this episode, we're going to look at three different Weller soldering stations, starting from the bottom end of the Weller range, and then looking at a mid-range, and then the top end of what Weller produces. This is a WHS40 from Weller. This is their entry-level, consumer market, if you like, soldering station. And I have to say, given the fact that the soldering iron stand is on the left, when, unless you're left-handed, which most people aren't, it should be on the right, it kind of fails from the very beginning. I mean, other than that, it's kind of difficult to use. The controls are small, the cable is cheap, the soldering pencil itself is bad. I mean, well, I wouldn't buy one. Sorry. So this is a bit more like it. This is the WS81, which is a mid-range soldering station that Weller produce. And you can see just looking at it, there's so much better quality than that WHS40 that we just looked at. Looking at the power supply unit itself, the PU81, it's an 80-watt power supply. It has enough power to drive a fairly large iron. You can set the temperature nice and easily just using this little control knob. It has an LED that shows you whether it's heating or cooling. And the cable is locked in so it won't fall out. Power switch is where it should be, right on the front of the unit there. It's heavy and it will sit down on the desk, and I mean, it's neat and tidy and there's not really very much to go wrong with it. If we look at the actual soldering iron itself, or the soldering pencil as well, I like to call these smaller ones, you can see it's got this nice little thumb screw. It's really easy to get that tip on and off as you're doing SMD work and you want to be able to solder small things, solder big things. And it's quite ergonomic and small, doesn't really get in the way of what you're doing. I mean, I've used one of these for about 15 years, actually, the previous version of this soldering station, and it just works and works and works. It's really, really good. So this is a WX1012. This is pretty much top of the range when it comes to the types of soldering stations that Weller do. I mean, if you look at this power supply unit, not only does it supply a whopping 200 watts of power, it has a touch screen, it has this lovely little iPod style dial for setting the temperature. You can even connect to it things like fume extractors and preheating plates and all sorts of accessories that you need when you're doing more high-end kind of surface mount type of work with these devices. It even has a USB port, which according to the manufacturer, you can use for data logging the tip temperature of your soldering iron. Why you would ever want to do that, I don't know, but hey, USB port. So let's look at the soldering pencil itself. The first thing to say about this is it has a motion detector built into the pencil. So as soon as you take the soldering pencil away from the stand, it will automatically turn on and heat up for you. And you can actually program it so that when you put it back in, after a predetermined amount of time, it will automatically shut itself down, which is nice. I mean, that's green. It saves a little bit of power. It also has a light built right into the handle that lets you see when the tip is at the operating temperature. The other thing I would say about these pencils themselves is that it's very nice and easy to get the tip out. You basically just unscrew this end here and you don't actually have to hold on to the hot part of the solder iron. You can see that you can easily get that tip off, and it's very quick and simple to be able to change that. You can even move this up and down and set the angle that you want for this particular stand. I mean, there's no expense spared, and it's reflected in the cost, it has to be said. So the question remains, which one of these three soldering irons would I buy? Well, there's a pretty simple way of solving that sort of problem in my house. Honey, do you mind if I spend 550 euros on a soldering iron?
Let me think about that for a second. No.
So, the WS81 it is then. So that's it for this episode. If you'd like to make some suggestions for things for me to review in the future, please feel free to comment. And if you like this video, please subscribe.